Well, I mean, you're certainly welcome to think that. But you also think that the United Nations is involved in replacing the people of Britain with other people.
What is the UN Migration Compact?
Right.
What is
so
that?
What
the
do you?
The Barcelona Declaration, 1995.
It's a report. It's the United Nations report, Robert.
Right.
How old will you be in 2066?
How old will I be? I'll be dead.
Oh, right. So why do you care then?
Wow, that's a nihilist thing to say, isn't it?
Well, why do you care what happens after you die?
Why do I care what happens after I die? What about my children? What about their future?
How many children have you got? How many children have you got, Robert?
I haven't got any yet.
Oh, you haven't got any? Right.
No, I haven't.
So you're worried about something you don't have?
No, it's not just about me, though, is it? It's about our children's future.
Like, you don't have any children. You don't have any children.
What's wrong? Why? Because, well, I want to have children.
Well, do you?
Should I not consider...
Are you married?
No.
Oh,
I'm not.
All right.
So that makes me, my point of view invalid, right?
No, it doesn't. It means that you're like one of those Ramonas that's worried about leaving the European Union because you don't know what's going to happen. You're worried about something because you've read something on the internet that you think is true, but it isn't. I think you should lighten up, Robert, and take a chill pill, go for a lie down in a dark room, and call me when you're feeling better. This is Talk Radio.
Oh, Mike, what are we going to do with you? In Britain, we seem to be inundated with self-proclaimed, tough-talking, common-sense, no-bullshit talk radio hosts who run shows encouraging the public to call in to talk about politics or current events. They usually frame themselves as being outspoken, anti-establishment rebels who are generally pro-Brexit, anti-Corbyn, and now think they're the cutting edge because they enjoy making fun of the lefty snowflakes on Twitter. It's all very basic bitch stuff. Things we've been doing for years and are really just bored with at this point, but it's also a sign of where the Overton window is, like I've mentioned in previous videos. While casual listeners may be able to find some enjoyment from people like, I don't know, Nick Ferrari or Julia Hartley Brewer, big issues, the important issues, such as demographic change, will never be touched on. The topics of discussion will be kept in an acceptable, mainstream zone, and nobody will hear anything new. Mike Graham, however, due to his own massive ego, has foolishly drawn a target over his own radio show for people like us. This started earlier this week when he insulted a caller who was talking about replacement migration.
To pay for these
I think you've been smoking that funny tobacco, Mary. I'm going to let you go.
Maybe Mike would have gotten away with the rudeness, but then he made the ultimate fatal error by claiming there's no such thing as Indigenous Britons.
Look, the point is, we have an immigration problem in parts of this country. It is not because the United Nations has sent people here to replace the people who are the Indigenous people of this country, because guess what? There are no Indigenous people of this country.
I wonder, would he say the same about countries like India or Japan? Yeah, I doubt it. This is the same tired old nonsense that leftists and establishment media have been throwing at us for years. There's no such thing as an ethnic Briton. We're a nation of immigrants. You know how it goes. Mike's dismissive attitude inspired a team of groypers led by Chris at Patriotic Talk to call into his show and constantly pressure him on demographic replacement. As usual, Mike responded childishly and said something that revealed not only his true colours, but the overall true colours of the establishment media, who have been feeding the public a message of destructive nihilism on a consistent basis.
How old will you be in 2066?
How old will I be? I'll be dead.
Oh, right. So why do you care then?
Wow, that's a nihilist thing to say, isn't it?
Well, why do you care what happens after you die?
Yes. Why care about something in the future? You'll be dead. Why give any thought to the coming generations, the future of your country? You won't be around to see it. So just live for the moment, loser. Go out and have fun. Buy expensive things. Shelter yourself with soulless entertainment and frivolities. This mindset is the cancer of the modern West. It has infected our media, clearly, and our politics. The MPs in Westminster don't think 50 or 100 years into the future. Oh no, they think 5 years into the future. They think of nothing but the next election cycle, of how they can preserve their own positions. And this hollowness filters down to the public. That's why people live to consume, why they're so careless with their personal health, and also, I would say, why fewer people are having children. To care about a future you yourself will never see requires you to be connected to your people, a collectivist outlook, but people like Mike Graham don't see the world that way. He can only see as far as his gut. I'm not going to go through all of the calls. I'm not sure if talk radio will try and copyright strike me or something, but this is fair use, so if they do attempt that, I will fight them on it. But all of Mike's shows can be found on the official Talk Radio YouTube channel. There are a couple of blatant examples, however, that perfectly showcase not only Mike's schoolyard behaviour, but his complete ignorance and denial of simple truths.
Yeah, I mean, we're already a minority in certain places in this country, one of those being our own capital city. And I don't think that's right. I think everywhere...
Well, you think, you think white people are in a minority, do you?
I do, yeah.
You ever been to Scotland?
Our capital city, London, we are a minority there.
Are you sure?
Mike, it's all over the internet.
Oh, it's all over the internet, right. Well, there's a lot of things all over the internet.
Find Google and find official statistics provided by governments.
Well, tell me one government statistic that says we're in a minority.
Well, I'm out and about it a minute, but if you wanted to, I could find it.
All right, then. Well, maybe when you find it, you could let me know what it is, and then you can call me back.
This caller informed Mike that white Brits were already a minority in London, their own capital city. Mike's response, as you saw, was dismissive and passive-aggressive. Yes, the caller should have had actual information in front of him so Mike couldn't reel him in with his bullshit antics. But calling radio shows can be nerve-wracking, and Mike does this for a living every day, so I'm not going to be too harsh. The caller, though, was right. And if Mike wants confirmation of those stats, may I direct him to the official government census of 2011, which clearly highlights the dwindling demographics of British people in London. It's not that hard to find. So, there you go, big boy. Try not to have an aneurysm when you read it.
For the first time ever, the number of people who class themselves as white British is now a minority in London. The 2011 census results out today show 45% of Londoners are now white British, while Barking and Dagenham have seen the biggest change of all. From there, here's Paul Brand.
The people of Barking are on the move. Migration in and out is transforming this population, a town which the census shows is altering more than anywhere else in the UK. Speak to any of the stallholders here and they will tell you that the face of this town is rapidly changing, and today's statistics prove them right. In the past 10 years, the proportion of people in Barking and Dagenham who describe themselves as white British has fallen by 31%, while the number of black Africans has risen by 11%. In 2001, 27% of people in London were born outside the UK. Over 10 years, that's grown to 37%. Of those born abroad, the largest proportion have moved here from India, closely followed by Poland, with the overall makeup of the capital's population changing dramatically. In 2001, a majority of Londoners, 58%, were white British. By 2011, that had fallen to 45%, a minority of the population.
The next caller, Sarah, did incredibly well and came prepared, but look at how Mike deals with her.
Well, why don't you quote what's on the ONS statistics about demographic replacement?
Well, why don't you read it out to me, and that way you can't then accuse me of not allowing you to do it?
Certainly. In short, the Indigenous British people will be a minority in England by 2060. You said this was wrong, but you won't discuss it with anyone. Why?
I'm discussing it with you, Sarah. How am I not discussing it with anyone?
Yes, Mike encouraged her to explain her position, yet began fake snoring over her when she did. This is deflection tactic 101. Make fun of your opponents, don't actually give them any substantial time to make their argument, and frame yourself as a martyr of common sense, putting the loonies in their place. Oh, genius. Then he lands what he thinks is the knockout blow.
Why don't you just admit, Sarah, that you don't like brown people? Why don't you just tell me that? Why don't you just admit you don't like brown people? A load of old cobblers about some nonsense, which is basically racist. Well, why don't you tell me why you don't like brown people?
You know what? If I had no prior knowledge of Mike Graham and I heard this exchange, I'd mistake him for a journalist at The Guardian. Shut it down, Mike! Call her a racist! Imply malicious intent behind her words. That's how you do it. Tried and tested. His next form of attack is to reduce the conversation into nonsensical nitpicking over language, deconstructing the entire thing once again to try and catch out the caller. But in reality, just making himself look like a retard.
Can you tell me how somebody next door to you has been replaced by somebody else? Have you got a theory on that?
Yes, it's on the ONS.
No. I'm looking for actual evidence. You're telling me that people are being replaced. Can you tell me of any friends of yours who have been taken away and replaced? Do you know what the word replace means? It means taking something away and replacing it with something else. Do you understand what that actually means?
We're talking about population percentages, Mike. Look at London again. White Brits are an ever-shrinking section of the population. Areas of London that used to be unmistakably English are now populated with people from the Third World. Ever heard of white flight? Look at Birmingham, where whites are very close to being a minority as well. They probably already are, to be honest with you. This never used to be the case, Mike, so what is happening? Can you explain this away? But it's pointless arguing with someone like him because he doesn't want to know the truth to begin with. Talk Radio, and this is precious, Talk Radio actually posted a 25-minute compilation of Mike arguing with callers on demographics, thinking it actually showed him in a good light. It's quite incredible, really. The link to that video is down below, just for your information. The ratio is, well, it's interesting. Mike also likes to give it the big one on Twitter. The other day, he called Laura Towler an illiterate nobody. Because, you know, he's such a big superstar and all that. And when she challenged him to a debate, he told her to call his radio show. Well, she did. And guess what? They didn't put her through. Oh, never mind. Says a lot, doesn't it? Really says a lot about the character of Mike and his producers. There are plenty of other calls I could dissect, plenty of points I could go in deeper on, but I've made countless videos on these very issues that you can watch for a better perspective. The overall point here, though, is people like Mike Graham and his so-called edgy colleagues in the media. They're nothing more than gatekeepers. Their job is to control the narrative, to direct public opinion. Anything that doesn't fit with that agenda is aggressively shut down, and the individuals involved personally smeared. At the end of the day, and this is the best part, Mike Graham is no different than the liberal elites he rallies against. He peddles a lame, worthless sort of civic nationalism. Or not even that, to be honest, it's just nothingness. These people show a complete lack of respect for the British public, they think of themselves as an authority on the issues of the day, and they are misleading genuine people down a harmful path that will ultimately lead to their demise. But hey, that's okay. Mike Graham will be dead by then, so why should he care? However, to finish this video off, I really do need to thank Mike Graham, actually. Because his actions this week have opened the door for demographics to be discussed on mainstream radio shows. If anyone thinks this will stop with Mike, you're wrong. Any show with a public call-in format will be hit, and the message will spread. Thanks to Mike, his regular audience have now been exposed to these things, and that's an overall positive thing. By the way, here's the phone number for Mike's show, which he does every weekday from 10 a.m. to 1 p.m. I'm just going to leave that here. Thank you all so much for watching once again. The links to support my channel are down below if you're feeling so inclined. Thank you so much to my credited patrons. If you'd like to get your name at the end of my videos, click on my Patreon link down below and look at the reward tiers. Okay, that's it from me. I will see you all next week. Have a good one.